Please click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates on civil engineering concepts. In this video, I will explain you complete analysis and designing of G plus 6 story oblique column and building by using StatPro V8i software. So oblique column and building is nothing but the inclined column that will be exist for some buildings due to the effect of the architectural purpose. Okay. So initially I will show you the model for that respected G plus 6 story oblique column and building. So click on StatPro software. So this is my oblique column and building. I was already done my modeling process for this respected building. So I will explain you how to model this respected structure. After that, I will explain you how to design this respected oblique column and building by using StatPro V8i software. So for that, initially we need to click on StatPro software. So click on StatPro software here. So click on new project option, select the spacing option. Initially I am giving the structure name, let us consider it as oblique column and building OBC. So save your file format as per your location and select the length units will be in meter as well as force units will be in kilonewton. Click on next button, click on finish button. So after that, initially we need to keep the structure in front of you. Initially we need to model the ground story building for this respective structure. So for that, go to geometry here, click on run structure wizard. So in this we need to select the model type is frame models, select the bay frame option. Initially I am assuming the length of the building which is consisting of 15 meter. Again I am taking the height of the building will be consisting of ground story which is equals to 3 meter. And I am taking the width of the building is 12 meter. Number of bays along length direction just I am taking it as 5. And high direction are 1 and width direction are 4. Click on apply option. So after that we have to import this respected model from structure wizard option to StatPro software. So for that click on cancel option, click on next button. Click on OK. Now the model is imported to this respective StatPro software like this. So after that we have to select the front view option in order to make the oblique column for the first story. So click on cut section command, click on select to view option, click on OK. Here we have to cut this respected portion. So after that we have to go to selection of your node cursor. So select all the kinds of the nodes initially. So after that click on copy option. So click on paste notes option. And we need to enter the height of the first story will be of 3 meter. Click on OK. So after that we have to select the left hand side 3 node points. Click on cut section here. So click on S option. So after that click on paste notes here. And we have to enter this respected X direction distance. So just I am taking it as 0.5. Click on OK. So it will move your respected nodes from 0 to 0.5 here. In the same way we have to move the right hand side nodes also. Click on cut section. So click on S option. Click on paste notes. In the same way, we have to move to the X direction minus 0.5, click on OK. So after that, we have to connect this respected node points with the help of the beams. So for that, initially we need to rotate this respected structure. So here we have to connect all the node points with the help of the beams. Select the beam here, select the first node point, second node point, third node point, first node point, second node point. In the same way, we have to connect all the node points with the help of the beams for these respected sections. So after that again we have to click on front view. Now in the same way we have to select the cut section command here. Click on select view. So here we have to click on OK option. Again select the node cursor. So here we have to cut these respected nodes. Again we have to select these respected node points. Go to click on copy option. Click on paste nodes which is at a distance of 3 meter again. So click on OK. So select the front view option. So again in the same way we have to select the node cursor. So here we have to select the nodes, again select this respected left hand side 3 nodes. So click on cut option, click on S option. So click on paste nodes here. So again we have to move this respected nodes to 0.5 meter. Again in the same way we have to select the right hand side section, cut section, click on S. So click on paste nodes. Again in the same way we have to move this respected options to minus 0.5, click on OK. So after that we have to save this model and we have to click on 3D model. So now we have to connect this respected nodes with the help of the oblique columns. So for that we have to select the 3D view here. So click on add beam. So we have to connect this respected beams. So after that click on 3D view here. So again select the front view option. So again we have to cut section command, click on select view, click on OK. So here we have to cut this respected portion. So now we have to select all the node points at this respected position. So click on copy option, click on paste nodes which is at a distance of 3 meter height, click on OK. So now we have to select all these 3 node points. So click on cut option, so click on S option. So click on paste notes, which is at a distance of X direction distance of 0.5 here. Click on OK. You have to select the right hand side node points. Click on cut option. Click on S option. Click on paste notes in X direction distance of minus 0.5. Click on OK. So click on S button. So after that, we have to select all these respective right hand side section and left hand side section node points. Click on copy option. Click on paste notes. So after that, we have to click on 3D view. So now we have to connect these respected node points with the help of the column sections. So select add beam command, select the first point, second point. In the same way, we have to add the column sections, oblique column sections for this model. So after that, we have to click on front view option. So we have to select all the node points at the top. So we have to select the right hand side node point, left hand side node point. No need to select this respected center node point. So click on copy option, click on paste notes, which is at a distance of 3 meter here. Click on OK. Now we have to select the left hand side node point. Click on cut here. Click on S option. Again, we have to paste these respective node points with at a distance of 0.5. In the same way, we have to select the right hand side section node point, cut option, click on S option, click on paste notes, which is at a distance of minus 0.5 here, click on OK. So after that, we have to click on cut section command, click on select to view, click on OK. So here we have to select this respected node cursor, select these nodes here like this. Again, we have to select the ground story nodes. So select this respected option. So now we have to connect this respected node points with the help of oblique columns in the same way. So after that, click on the front view option here. Again, we have to select the node cursor, select these top nodes, go to click on copy option, click on paste nodes, which is at a distance of 3 meter height. Again, we have to select the left hand side nodes, click on cut here, click on S option. Again, click on paste nodes, which is at a distance of 0.5. Again, I am selecting right hand side node, click on cut option, again click on S option, again click on paste nodes, which is at a distance of minus 0.5 here, click on OK. Now we have to click on cut section command, click on selective view, click on OK. So here we have to cut this respected portion. Now we have to select the node cursor, select the all the nodes at the base, click on OK. Now we have to connect this respected node point with the help of the oblique columns. So after that, again select the front view option. So here we have to select the cut section command, select to view, click on OK. So here we have to select the node cursor, select these nodes. Again, I am selecting the nodes here. Click on copy, click on paste nodes, which is at a distance of 3 meter height. Click on OK. So now I am selecting these nodes. Click on cut section, yes option. Click on paste nodes, which is at a distance of 0.5 meter. So again, I am selecting this respected right hand side distance cut section. Click on S option. Again, I am selecting paste nodes, which is at a distance of minus 0.5 here. Click on OK. So after that, we have to click on select your respected node cursor, select this node points, click on 3D view. So initially, we need to measure the distance between each node point. So here, the distance is 3 meter. So we need to stop this respected oblique columns till the 3 meter height. So click on OK. So after that, we have to draw this respected connections with the help of oblique columns. So after drawing all oblique columns, we need to click on whole structure command. So initially we need to select the front view. So it will show you your respected model here like this. Select the node cursor, select all the node points from the first story to the last story. So click on 3D view. So it will select all your node points. Go to geometry here, click on connect beams along X axis. So it will connect your respected beams in X axis. Again, click on geometry, click on connect beams along Z axis. So it will connect all your respected beams here like this. So after that, we have to model the slabs for this respected section. So for that, select your front view option, go to cut section command, click on select view, click on OK. So here I'm cutting this respected portion, click on 3D view. Initially, we need to model the slab for the top sections. So here I'm selecting first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point. Select this plate cursor, select this respected plate, transitional repeat in X direction. It will be consisting of remaining sections are 4. Each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. Again, in the same way, we have to select all the node points. So here I'm selecting Z direction, which is consisting of number of steps are 3. Each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So now I'm selecting whole structure command. Again, we have to select the front view. So here we have to cut this respected portion for the second story. So select the beam cursor. So here I'm selecting this respected portion. Select the top view. So here I'm selecting add 4 node plate option. Select first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point. Again I'm selecting first node point here. Again I'm selecting second node point, third node point, fourth node point. In the same way, just I'm adding first, second, third, fourth. So after that we have to select the first node point, second, third, fourth. Again I'm selecting first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point. Now we have to select the plate cursor, select all these respected plates, transitional repeat, in Z direction number of steps are 3, each step will be consisting of 3 meter, click on OK. So here we have to save this respected model initially, so after that select the front view, so click on host HR command, so here I am selecting cut section command again we have to select to view, click on OK, again I am selecting beams here. So in the same way we have to repeat this respected procedure till the last story. So after that click on 3D view here, so click on 3D rendering view. So after that we have to select the 3D rendering view for this respected process. So it will show you a respected model of G+6 story oblique column and building like this. So after modeling process completed, we need to apply the properties. So select general option, properties, so click on define option, select the rectangular section. So initially I am taking the column size which is consisting of 0.5 × 0.3 oblique column and size. So after that just I am considering beam size will be consisting of 0.35 × 0.3. So after that just I am editing the thickness of the slab which is equals to 150 mm, click on add button, close option. So after that select this respected beams. So we have to select beams parallel to X condition. Again I am selecting beams parallel to Z condition, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. So after that select the plate thickness by using assign to view option, assign yes option. So after that we have to select the 0.5 × 0.3, which is nothing but the oblique column and properties. So we have to select properties by missing attribute, missing property. So before assigning the properties, we need to divide this respected section with the help of the groups. So go to tools option here. So click on create new group. So give the name as oblique column and building OBC. Let us consider. So here I am taking OBC and which is select type as beam, click on OK. So here we have to select the associate to selected geometry, associate option. So after that we have to select beams by missing attribute, missing property. So click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that we have to see this respected model in rendering view, click on this 3D rendering view option. So this is the 3D rendering view for this respected oblique column and building. It will be consisting of G+6 stories with 0.5 × 0.3 is the oblique column and size, and 0.35 × 0.3 is the beam size, and slab thickness will be consisting of 150 mm. So after that we have to apply the supports, select the supports option, create option, add your fixed support, select your support to with the help of front view option. We need to select all the node points at the base. So click on assign to selected nodes, assign yes option. So after that we have to apply the load cases for this respected structure. So for this structure just I am assuming the load cases will be consisting of dead loading condition, live loading condition, and seismic loading condition as well as wind loading condition. Select loads and definitions initially, click on define, select the seismic definitions, add button. Initially I am selecting the Indian standard system, click on generate. So here I am selecting the zone which is of fourth condition, which is having 0.24 is the seismic coefficient value with the special RC moment resisting fins, and for all general buildings and medium soil condition with the damping ratio is 0.05. click on generate option. So after that we have to add this respected property, click on add your self weight. So after that we have to add the member weight which is related to the dead load of the beam, which is equals to 0.35 × 0.3 multiplied by 25, which is equals to 2.625. so here we have to enter 2.625, click on add button, close option, select this respected values. So we need to select beams parallel to X condition, again we have to select beams parallel to Z condition, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that we have to define the wind loading condition, select the wind definitions, add button. So initially we need to add type 1 wind on, add, close, select type 1 wind on, add button. So here we have to define the intensity. Let us consider the intensity of 1.2 which is acting at a distance of 21 meter. Again I am taking one intensity which is acting at a distance of 15. So we need to calculate this respective expected intensity as per your IS-875 code. I will provide you that respected video in above code link. You can check that video. So here I am assuming this respected intensity values as per my rough considerations. So here I am taking 0.2, which is at a 3. Click on add button. So after that we have to add the exposure as 1, add, close. Select the exposure one by using assign to view, assign yes option. So after that we have to define the load case details. Click on add. Initially we need to add the seismic loading condition. So we have to give the title as earthquake load, which is in X. Again we have to add the earthquake load, which is in Y condition, add button. So here again I am selecting the wind load, which is related to the X direction condition. So for that select the wind, give the name as WX, add. Again I am selecting WY, add. Now I am selecting the dead loading condition, give the title as DL, add. Again I am selecting live loading condition, give the title as LL, add, close. So after the select earthquake load X direction condition, click on add button. Initially we need to select the seismic loading condition in X direction with the factor 1, add, close. Select Y direction, add button. Select the seismic loading condition with the factor as Z with 1, add it, close option. Select the wind load in X direction, add button. In the same way we have to select the wind load in X direction with the windward facing with factor 1. Again I am adding the factor as -1, add button, close option. Select wind Y, add button. So initially we need to select the wind load here. So select in Z condition windward facing with factor 1, add button. Again I am selecting -1 factor, add, close. So select the dead loading condition, add, select the self weight, add, close. Select the self weight here, assign to view, assign yes. Select the live load here, add option. Initially we need to select the floor load, which is having the intensity of -3, which is acting at a distance of 3 and 21. Click on add, close. Select this respected value. So this is the live load for this respected structure. So after that we have to add the load combinations. Select add button. Select auto load combinations as per the Indian standard system code. Click on generate, click on add, click on close. So after that go to analysis and print, add your no print, close option, go to analyze option, run analysis, save it. So here we have to check for the zero errors for this respected model. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observed with zero errors. Go to post processing mode, click on done option, apply, okay. So this is the deflection diagram for this respective structure due to presence of the live loading condition and earthquake load X direction condition, earthquake load Z direction condition, dead loading condition, as well as your live loading condition. So after that we have to select the beam. So deselect MZ value, select FY value. So this is the shear force diagram for this respective structure due to presence of live load, earthquake load X direction, earthquake load Y direction. So after that we have to select MZ value. So here we have to select the dead loading condition. So this is the bending moment diagram for this respective structure. So after that select the plate, apply your stress type as absolute pressure, click on apply, click on OK. So this is the absolute pressure for this respected diagram due to earthquake load X direction condition, earthquake load Y direction, wind load X, wind load Z, dead loading condition, live loading condition. So after that we have to click on animation option, click on deflection, click on apply, click on OK. So this is the deflection due to presence of live load, this is the deflection due to presence of dead load, earthquake load X direction condition, wind load in X direction condition. So after analysis process completed, we need to design this respective structure. So for that go to modeling, click on design, select the concrete design. So here I am selecting IS-456 code. So click on select parameters. Initially we need to select all parameters. Select compressed strength, yield strength, yield strength of shear reinforcement, maximum main, maximum secondary. Click on OK. So after that click on define parameters. So here we have to add the M40 grid. So 40,000, click on add option. Again I am selecting FY main, let us consider it as 600,000. Click on add button. So after that we have to add FY section reinforcement 600,000. Click on add option. Again I am selecting maximum main, let us consider it as 20 mm, add button. Maximum secondary 12 mm, add button, close option. Select commands here. Select design beam command, click on add button, design column command, click on add button, slab element command, click on add button, takeoff command, click on add button, close option. So after that select this respected question marks by using assign to view, assign yes. So after that FY main also assign to view, assign yes. FY section assign to view, assign yes. Maximum main assign to view, assign yes. Maximum secondary assign to view, assign yes option. Select design beam command, we have to select beams parallel to X condition. Again we have to select beams parallel to Y condition. Click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. So after that we have to select the columns. So here we have to select by group name here. So here I am selecting OBC. So click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that select design element by using assign to view, assign yes option. So after that we have to select the analysis and print, add your no print, close option, go to analyze option, run analysis, save here. So again we have to check for the zero errors for this respected design also. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observed with zero errors. Go to post processing mode, click on done option. So select beam here. So deselect the beam event diagram, select any one of the beam. So double click on it, click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design, it is needed. 8 bars of 10 mm dia, 320 center to center distance at the top reinforcement, and 8 bars of 10 mm dia at 30 center to center distance at the bottom reinforcement. And it is needed 10 bars of 8 center to center distance of 140 for this respected beam. So after that we have to select any one of the top beam, double click on it, click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design, it is needed 8 bars of 10 mm dia, 320 center to center distance, and 8 bars of 10 mm dia, 30 center to center distance at the bottom for this respected M40 grade concrete. So after that we have to select any one of the column, double click on it, click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design for this respected section. It will be consisting of 12 number of bars which is having 12 mm size, and AST percentage is 0.90, AST requirement is 1200 mm square. So after that we have to select any one of the oblique column and select this respected option, double click on it, click on concrete design. So this is the oblique column and reinforcement details. It is also consisting of 12 bars of 12 mm dia, 0.9 is the AST percentage, 1200 mm square is the AST requirement for M40 grade concrete. So after designing this respected structure, we need to see the output file. So click on start output file option. So click on results option here. So click on concrete design option. So it will show your each and individual calculation sheet for this respected oblique column and building. So after designing this respected structure, we need to design the foundation. So select the foundation design. Initially we need to select the load cases which is related to the seismic loading, dead loading, live loading. So click on include here. So click on run start foundation. The fixed supports of this respected oblique column and building will be directly imported to your respected start foundation software. So these are the fixed supports. We need to design the foundation for this respected fixed supports. So initially we need to generate the load cases. So select loads and factors here. So click on generate load combinations, select it as Indian standard system. So click on generate load combinations for the service load combination. So after that click on generate load combinations for the ultimate load combination, click on OK. So after that we have to define the job setup, create job. So click on job name. So here I am considering oblique column building OBC. So select your job title as isolated as per the Indian standard system, and units will be in SI. So here we have to select the load combinations as per your selection, 101, 102, 201, 202, 203, 204, include this, click on create job. So it will create your isolated footing job like this. Select the isolated footing job. So click on concrete and rebar value, cover and soil type, footing geometry, sliding and overturning, click on design option, click on S button. So it will design your respected foundation as per IS 456-2000 code. So this is the isolated footing design as per IS 456-2000 code. Select any one of the foundation. So this is the foundation design as per IS 456-2000 code for this oblique column and building. So select starting page, geometry, details and drawing. So click on GA drawing option, click on calculation sheet. So this is the process analysis and designing of oblique column and building by using StatPro V8i software. Thank you.